We want to solve this triangle given the length of one of the sides and the measure of two of the angles. To keep things organized, let's go ahead and label the vertices and the sides. So let's call this vertex A, B, and C. Therefore, side A is opposite angle A, side B is opposite angle B, and side C is opposite angle C. Right away, if we're given two interior angles of a triangle, we should be able to determine the third angle because we know the sum of the interior angles must be 180 degrees. So the measure of angle B would be equal to 180 degrees minus 132 degrees minus 18 degrees. So the measure of angle B is going to be equal to 30 degrees. Now if we take a look at the information that we have, notice that we have the measure of an angle and the length of the opposite side. And therefore we can solve this triangle using the law of sines. So let's go ahead and start by determining the length of side C. So if we want to determine side C, we'll have to have the sine of angle C divided by C. So we'll have the sine of 132 degrees divided by C must equal the sine of 18 degrees divided by 7. Remember, to set this up, we can only have one unknown value, and here the only unknown is C. Now we can cross multiply and solve for C. So we'll have C sine 18 degrees must equal 7 times sine 132 degrees. So now we'll divide both sides by sine 18 degrees. And this quotient will give us the length of side C. Let's make sure that we're in degree mode. And we are. So the numerator is going to be 7 sine 132 degrees. And we're going to divide this by sine 18 degrees. So the length of side C is approximately 16.8. And this would be meters. And now we're left to determine the length of side B. So we'll go ahead and set up a similar proportion. But since we want to determine the length of side B, we're going to have the sine of angle B divided by the length of side B, or sine 30 degrees. Divided by B must equal, let's go ahead and use the same ratio of sine 18 degrees divided by 7. And now it's the same process. We'll cross multiply and then solve for B. So we have B times sine 18 degrees must equal 7 times the sine of 30 degrees. So now we'll divide by sine 18 degrees again. And this quotient will give us the length of side B. So our numerator is 7 sine 30 degrees divided by sine 18 degrees. So the length of side B is approximately 11.3 meters. And now we have the length of all of the sides and the measure of all of the angles, so we have solved this triangle.